Convergent, divergent, transform. Have you ever wondered how this type of plate boundaries help shape the Earth's geologic features? In the next few minutes, we will explore science for another moment. Hello, SciPals! I am Ambeth Aquino, your science teacher for today. In this episode of Agham Alabhab, we are going to explain the different processes that occur along the plate boundaries. We will find out how geologic features such as mountains, mountain ranges, volcanoes, rift valleys, trenches and oceanic ridges are formed. Furthermore, we will identify the different processes along the divergent, convergent, and transform fault boundaries, and we'll determine the consequences of the movements of these plates. Can you still remember the three types of plate boundaries based on the movements of plates? The first type of plate boundary is divergent plate boundary. The second type of the plate boundary is convergent plate boundary. Can you guess the third type of the plate boundary? Right! The third type of plate boundary is transform fault boundary. Now, let us recall how each of these plates moves. In divergent plate boundary, the plates move apart. In convergent plate boundary, the plates move towards each other. In transform fault boundary, the plates slide or grind past each other without diverging or converging. Describing the different types of plate boundaries and their movement would help us better understand the different processes that occur along them. Divergent boundary is a region where the crustal plates are moving apart. What do you think will form when two plates move away from each other? Along these boundaries, earthquakes are common where the magma rises from the Earth's mantle to the surface and solidifies. Most divergent boundaries are situated along underwater mountain ranges called oceanic ridges. When a spreading center develops within a continent, the crust may break into several segments. The breaking leads to formation of downfaulted valleys called rift valleys. Meanwhile, when the two plates of the convergent boundary move towards each other, the impact of the colliding plates can cause the edges of one or both plates to buckle up into mountains or mountain ranges, or one of the plates may bend down into a deep seafloor trench. This happens when the denser oceanic crust descend below the edge of the continental crust. This process is called subduction. In addition, volcanoes are often formed parallel to convergent plate boundaries, and powerful earthquakes are common along these boundaries. However, when the two plates of a transform fault boundary slide past each other, the immediate concerns are earthquake activities triggered by the movements along the fault system. In this episode of Agham Alabhab, you learned about the processes that occur along the plate boundaries and found out how geologic features such as mountains, mountain ranges, volcanoes, rift valleys, trenches, and oceanic ridges are formed. As plate moves away from one another along the divergent plate boundary, rift valleys and oceanic ridges are formed. In convergent plate boundary, mountains, mountain ranges, trenches, and volcanoes are formed as a result of the collision of plates. On the other hand, the movement of plates in transform fault boundaries does not result to the formation of geologic features. Remember that all plate movements in convergent, divergent, and transform fault boundaries trigger earthquakes. That's all for today, SciPals. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell. See you again next week for another moment. Only here in Agham Alabhab, Palajan SciTech Portal. Bye!